delivery is for you. So good to see somebody when I start the 8th class and then now in my graduation final year, which is doing very good. So I'm sure if somebody says that you are not a good student, you cannot study, that's wrong. And that's not our task. Our task is to change them. With a lot of responsibility, I'm sure you can do it. So I think I only have to speak to you this much as an introduction. You have time? Up to what time? If you want to ask something, you can ask. Now I have told you something, right? Do a practical at the end. So close your eyes. Think about all the points which I told you. Make some 5 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, one priority. 5 points which you grabbed from this class, and then what difference it makes in your thoughts. How are you going to implement this? What could be one question which you can ask? Just think about it. It takes only a few minutes to think. A 20 minute talk can be have a fast forward review in 2 minutes. Open your eyes. You can relax. Hold your fingers like this. Take a deep stretch.
Let your ribs know you. Only know your ribs. Look at your neighbor.
Tell what it is meant to do. Done? So you have few points to speak, right? Okay, tell me, what did you get from the class? One contract, I can come and ask you, what did you learn? Great. And you will have to tell me 1 point. Fine? If you voluntarily tell, any point which somebody says, others cannot say. You understood how do you make your children active and reactive? Whoever says, they can say no. Volunteers have got chance. You can say that this is the point which I learned. A point which is told by one will not be repeated by anybody else. After finishing 10 of you, I will come to the 11th one and ask, tell me what is the point. Yeah, now there are a lot of volunteers, you see. Now you know the trick of making your children active in the class, right? You understood? That's why I said I want to make this a practical class. You tell me what's the point.
How to manage your class strategy.
Okay. Don't manage your class. Managing is a lower subject. Administer your class. Managing is, if you don't know cooking, I manage making a chapati. It's what? Managing is a bad word. When you do manage, I manage my class means what? You couldn't do well, right? So I administer. First time I used it because I managed it. Because I don't know whether you will cooperate or not, right?
If you want to be a good teacher, you should try to understand the students.
Yeah. That's it. Louder.
Good students do not need a teacher, but then it's bad ones who really need a mentor and teaching more things.
Market our subjects. Make them do more work and inspire them.
How do you test?
Our task is to make them to learn any subject.
Make them to learn, because subject happens to be one of the words. Give assignments to students, which they have never put it. Sir?
Understand the students by the...
Already said. Do you understand? When you have discussions, you will have to give your ear. Generally, when you ask questions, I'll ask them to go to your ear. It's a problem. Yeah. Who else? Any question? You ask them first. Answer for the
question.
Chemistry. What do you basically explain to you after this? You have a positive question here? After this, after this, what do you? Isn't the most demanding chemistry area in research? But where do they get a job? Do you think department of the chemistry department offers those chemistry people?
Yes.
But we have a good polymer chemistry. Yes, it's here for the good quality. It's called quality. And I was running a bottle lab. The bottle lab is full of things. Correct? You have to print satellite images and then just do it. I was experimenting in chemistry then because the satellite image is from a far off place like the
Earth is moving, satellite is moving. When you take picture, nothing will be visible. And we have got atmosphere. Therefore, no clear picture will come. And once we have got a picture of a road, which my job is to show a road which runs in Kashmir. In a snow area, a small road, at that height, nothing will be seen. So what we do is I do filter and then develop it. And then see whether if I use a yellow filter, then I know that this color will not be present. Then I use a reverse processing to make the picture up. What do you do in the brightness contrast adjustment in the TV? We have to do it on a print. All done through chemical analysis. That's what we do. Yeah. And each image should have different technology.
Teacher should try the students to teach cycling. Cycling. How to cycle, yes.
The technology is more important than the subject itself. A good cook. If I want to make somebody a good cook, I am not going to teach them all the variety of items. 10 items if I cook, teach them how to cook, the 11th item he will make himself, right? That's the question. Any questions?
Sir, some students have some fears about their answers and all. So how do we manage these situations?
Don't again manage. Right? Manage, try. These are all wrong sentences. If somebody asks you to come onto the stage, you say, I will try to come, means what? Your hand, leg is not working. Correct? Correct or not? If I cannot climb, I will say, I will try to climb. If I can climb, I will say, climb. So if they have a fear, the fear can be of three reasons. One is they don't have a skill. If I have to climb on a tree, if I have to swim, I should know swimming. So the skill is swimming. Second one, the environment is entirely different. Somebody can speak in front of LKG students. But if all professors come, you think your student will be able to that confidently do that? So environment matters. So they are not accustomed to different environments. Reason number two, that's where the confidence is from. First reason is skill is not. Third one is attitude. There are people, they can do it, but they don't have attitude. I know swimming pool is also available, but why should I bet? And that attitude is laziness. Correct? You must make them feel that these sort of trials are required for you. You have to swim in all conditions so that you become a better swimmer. Tell them it's required. And not for you, but for somebody else to realize that you have this ability, they get motivated, they will come to you to discuss. Correct? So what do you do? You must ask, make them to aspire. Sharing, caring, loving, learning, all these are part of your process of learning. There are a lot of children who have got good bright and they will say that, no, it's okay, not required, this is not my stage. My stage is much bigger than this. They will not discuss in smaller places, but some places they will become very active. That's possible. To the teachers in the classroom, they will know. But they come to the department, they will argue and tell you, this, I know. Why do you not tell them? Yeah, it doesn't matter. And sometimes they have got a lot of courage, lot of interest, so enthusiastic. All of a sudden they meet somebody and he says, you are useless, that's it. Or your subject is useless. I saw the other day, I came to DMS College. Where did you meet? BCM College. BCM College, lunchtime, one student came. She was doing zoology. And I was having lunch. The faculty there came and told, sir, one student is there who was very active. 2 weeks back, she stopped studying. She says, no, I don't want to study anymore. We were expecting rank from the student. That's so wonderful. So I said, go and get her. Sir, after lunch she will be. I said, I am already having lunch. You disturbed me as a faculty. Do you think faculty have more liberty than student? Or less students have less liberty? Let them come during the lunch itself. So she, it's her job now to hunt the student in the campus to find the girl. So he brought. I asked what happened. I could get some clue that it has been misguided by somebody. So I was giving one example, one person who was suggesting, and that's how it happened. One person who was giving a career guidance, she was telling that I attended a career guidance program. She don't want to tell who misguided it, Then I took an example and said, I used to go for such programs, and one person, another person will be me, another person will be a famous personality from the TV program, I'm not that famous. So they generally project one person who is famous, another knowledgeable person, that's what it is. And he was suggesting IAST you must join. And that person doesn't know that I'm the person who first note for IAST was from me. From Department of Space. I was in headquarters that time. And then after the suggestion went from him, I told him, IHT is not that good for your information. No Department of Scientist suggests the children to join IHT, first of all. The reason is, IHT, once you join and pass out, we train people to make them fit for Department of Space. They will not be fit for anything else. So in 4 years, if your intention of not there for joining IAST, you become mostly useless. Because we wanted scientists, they should not quit Department of Space. That's why we trained them to become Department of Space members. That's why IAST started the bitter program. I said, oh, is it? He said, you are a one person who is coming on to TV and giving hearings, you don't know what is the content of it. Correct? And he is the person who predicts, if you get this much rank, this college you get admission. How do you predict this? Percentile is not same every year. Unless that happens, that year's admission is closed, you cannot even predict it. And I thought there was one person who told this, and with his name I told this girl. Immediately, yes sir, same person told, zoology is useless. I said, finished, your problem is over. You didn't tell me who is the person, I told you who is the person. And he doesn't work, don't listen to him. And what's your intention? She said, her parents are doctors, her sister is doing PhD in IIT, and she is a highly meritorious student. I said, don't bother about somebody who says that he'll be the most knowledgeable person, your principal or vice chancellor, or maybe the UGC chairman comes and says you are useless. Why do you think that you are useless? No? Anyway, you are into this, do well. And I took my brother's example, he's a zoology man. He never went for any coaching. He joined as a teacher in one of the colleges. And then he wrote Indian Forest Service. And we retired last month as the chief of forest in Kerala. Very peaceful job. Not like other IAS, a very minister did not call and scold you. But that's a wonder. And he loves forest. And if you love forest, you like, love chemistry, zoology, botany, different options to be chosen in your life. There is one student who passed electrical engineering, BTEC, and then she found work in TCS for 3 years, and she found that's not her life. So she wrote that examination in JAM And she joined for life science PhD. So now there are options. If you just finished one graduation, that doesn't mean your end of your life is that. You can always shift. So your graduation students must tell them that this is one basic floor. You want to jump to any other place, you could jump. Irrespective of whichever field they are. There are a lot of options in this world. So it's essential to understand your student and then also understand that are the options available. As teachers, you have a high responsibility. So I see most of the time we go for mentoring sessions when we give talk, no teachers at all. Because we know everything. Career counseling program is given for children. Why should I know? See, your responsibility, my history student is going to listen to the options in history. Correct? And you must be able to suggest which is the best social science institute in India. If there is a bright student here with a social science background and if she is exceptionally brilliant, where do you suggest her to go? Okay? PG work. See, best science student, they should go to IAS, Indian Institute of Science. Startup by Tata. Best social science? Again Tata. There is only one answer. Best quality education. Tata is the end. Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, chemistry. Lot of options. TFR has got a chemistry center. TFR chemistry center is where Jim is working and then he is in the Indian Institute of ISER. He's there. Yes. He was in Hyderabad, Central University. My brother is also there in Hyderabad. Professor T.P. Radhakrishnan. They are colleagues. Sometimes they work in Bach. The center for Bach is the TFR center in Bangalore. My brother is also a chemist. So you must tell children now that you should appear for Tata's Institute of Fundamental Research. You must appear for Tata Institute of Social Science. You must show this is the path to go. Math Science Institute, you must go. Different branches of educational centers, where who can appear for what. That should be told to your children. Make them to aspire higher. That's what it is. Lot of fellowships. My son is earning more than what I'm earning in terms of fellowships. And he's also a social science student. He's an economist. And he's doing PhD in Kerala politics. But he's doing in Dublin. Only question, why are you doing Dublin Kerala politics? They pay money, therefore I'm doing it. That's so they get a lot of money. Education have sufficient and more fund internationally. My student is doing MS, the course fee is 2 crores and she's paying 0. Full fellowship, 2 crores. I made her to be eligible for that. Now the parent says, sir, you have gifted 2 crores to me. Tell me, sir, what you want. You can make a lot of money. The parents will come and tell you. Is it not great? So when your student becomes great, the credit is for you. Yeah. Any questions?
I have 33 years of experience as a teacher. Last day, from the students, do you believe that I have seen the whole world? Do you believe that I have seen the whole world? I said, no, I haven't seen the whole world. So there should be a change in the attitude of teachers. There is a learning teacher. Day by day, he should acquire as many knowledge as possible. There should be, unless there is an attitudinal change, unless a teacher changes, unless and until he changes, only he or she can change the students. But don't you want to emphasize? I mean, attitudinal change.
I think for you can be a teacher reproducing whatever knowledge you have, and survive to be a teacher with 35 years of experience. But that experience becomes one, repeated 30 times. Repetition is multiplication. One into one. And that becomes only one. A teacher who learns every day. Probably I must have done teacher's training like this for maybe a few minutes to talk to teachers. Maybe at thousands of places. But still a record. Because each time it has to be different. If it is not different, you are listening to me first time, but I am listening to me many times, it becomes boring for me. Every day, think of something. So today I was thinking, how should I make it slightly different? And that one thought is enough. Somewhere you will start getting a tag. You can make your class a class. And you feel happy, oh, I've done something new today, something great. And for which you will have to read any variation. Otherwise, teaching history, oh, history never changes, right? Economics never changes. But only thing when you want to relate to the today's present scenario, you will have to, correct? That is not in syllabus, it's out of syllabus anyway. But that relating is what makes your class entirely different. And as a math teacher, you speak something in English. Or as a botany teacher, you speak mathematics to your children. Or maybe botany students have got to learn chemistry. You have subsidiary chemistry here. Correct? Take one portion from that and relate that in botany. Because students are learning botany and chemistry, right? Hey, maybe a chemistry teacher speaks a little bit of botany. Student will look like, my teacher knows botany also, yeah, my chemistry teacher is great. And the respect to you will become 100 times higher. I tell you, this happens. Because they are studying both subjects, right? You take one of the poetry from your English textbook which they are learning and try to explain it. Which is the poetry which commonly everybody must be knowing. Not taken. When you explain it, a botany teacher can look at it in what style? Is there nature there? That's it. Correct or not? Botany is important. If you learn botany, you can write better poetry. If you learn geography, you can write better poems, right? Correct or not? നെല്ലിൽ അടുത്ത കാലത്ത് എവിടെ പ്രസംഗത്തിൽ അവർ പറഞ്ഞ് വയനാട്ടിലൊക്കെ ട്രിപ്പ് പോയി ഞാൻ നെല്ലിലെ പോയട്രി വായിച്ചിരുന്നു ഒരു സോങ് കാട് കുളിരുന്നു പറഞ്ഞൊരു പാട്ട് അത് ഫുൾ വയനാടിനെ ഡിസ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്യുന്നു വെച്ചു അത് കേട്ടിരുന്നു ഏയ് അതൊന്നും കേട്ടില്ല സർ ശരിക്കും വയനാട്ടിൽ പോകുമ്പോൾ പാടുന്ന പാട്ടതാണ് ഇഫ് യു സിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദെൻ ഡ്രൈവ് ഇൻ വയനാട് യു വിൽ എൻജോയ് വയനാട് ത്രീ ടൈംസ് ഹൈ That is what is education. Relate with what you know. So a teacher has got a lot of responsibility to relate. Inna enna chemistry padichirukku botany teacher. Then relate that chemistry to your botany class today. That's called relevance. Adhu nalla pole vaikkam. Enna vendiyo? Then you become a good reader. Then your knowledge will improve. Because you are all going to be in this field of business for next year. ഒരു ഒരു വലിയൊരു ഗുണം ഒരു പ്രാവശ്യം ടീച്ചറായിട്ട് മറുപടി പണി കിട്ടും യു വിൽ നോട്ട് ഗെറ്റ് എ ടീച്ചർ 100% ബട്ട് യു ഡു സംതിങ് എൽസ് യു കൻ ഓൾവേസ് ഗെറ്റ് ടു ടീച്ചർ കറക്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് ടീച്ചർ ആർ ദ മോസ്റ്റ് റിലാക്സിംഗ് ജോബ് യു ഹാവ് ഗോട്ട് എ ബോർഡ് എ ചോക്ക് ആൻഡ് എ ഡസ്റ്റർ റൈറ്റ് സംതിങ് ഡെയിലി ആലോചിക്കട്ടെ സ്റ്റേഷൻ മാസ്റ്റർ ഒരു മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് ചെയ്താൽ ഫിനിഷ്ഡ് ബാങ്ക് എംപ്ലോയി സാലറി അപ്പോൾ കട്ട് ചെയ്യും ഇവിടെയോ എന്ത് മിസ്റ്റേക്ക് ചെയ്തത് എത്ര സാലറി കട്ട് ചെയ്തത് ആൻഡ് ഡു യു ഹാവ് ടു വർക്ക് ഓവർ ടൈം മൈ വൈഫ് ഈസ് എ സയൻറ്റിസ്റ്റ് ദ അതർ ലാസ്റ്റ് സൺഡേ വി വർ അവേഴ്സ് ഇൻ മൈ ഹോം ടൗൺ ഓൾ മൈ ബ്രദേഴ്സ് സോ മൈ ബ്രദർ തെയ്യം കണ്ട് തിരിച്ചു വന്ന സമയത്ത് ഒരു 8:30 ഏട്ടം വിളിച്ചു എൻ്റെ വൈകിട്ട് ചുരാജയുടെയാണ് ഓഫീസിൽ സൺഡേ 8:00 ഇൻ ദ ഓഫീസ് ഐ ഡോ നോ ഹൗ മെനി ഓഫ് യു വിൽ ബി ഇൻ ദ കോളേജ് ആണോ അല്ലേ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു നോൺ വർക്കിംഗ് ഡേയ്സിലോ കുറച്ച് എക്സ്റ്റെൻഡ് ചെയ്താലോ ഉടനെ ചോദിക്കും ടി എ തരുമോ ഡി എ തരുമോ കോമ്പൻസേറ്റർ ഓഫ് തരുമോ ഭക്ഷണം തരുമോ ജസ്റ്റ് ചേഞ്ച് എവറി ഇൻഷുറൻസ് കമ്പനി കോട്ടയത്തൊക്കെ മാക്സിമം ക്ലാസ് എടുത്തുള്ള ഇൻഷുറൻസ് കമ്പനി കണ്ടു ഫോർ ഹാഫ് ഡേ ക്ലാസ് ലൈക്ക് ദിസ് ദേ പേ 1000 rupees പറഞ്ഞു എന്റെ ക്ലാസ്സിന് പേര് ദേ ഹാവ് ടു പേ 1000 റുപ്പീസ് ടു അറ്റൻഡ് എ ക്ലാസ് ആൻഡ് ടെൽ മീ ഹൗ മെനി ടീച്ചേഴ്സ് പേ ഫോർ ദർ പോക്കറ്റ് ഇംപ്രൂവ് ദർ നോളജ് യു ഡോണ്ട് ഹാവ് ടു ഷാർപ്പൺ യുവർ വെപ്പൺ യു ബിലീവ് ദർ ദിസ് കറക്റ്റ് മാത്തമാറ്റിക്സ് ടീച്ചേഴ്സ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ഇസ് ബാഡ് നോർമലി do you take an extra course to improve your English? No. Where is your classroom numerator? Where are you going denominator? Okay, then let me improve my English. No such. It's enough. I'm suffering like this. No, salary is I don't get it, something extra paid. But each one of your students keep you inside their heart. And if you can get a better place, your health will become better. People will pray for you. So, improve your life. A teacher should have good communication skill, good presence of mind, nice current affairs knowledge so that you can relate to the subject. Try to practice it. Practice it well. I had wonderful physics teachers in my childhood. Got good mathematics teachers. Masters, MSc level also. When I used to ask questions, he couldn't answer in the classroom. Evening, he used to come to hostel and explain. M.R. Kaiwan, Cochin University. He has come many times he came to my room. Because I used to ask questions, he couldn't answer. And asking questions which teachers cannot answer for. Oh, what a great career. And the idea is, go and refer books and then find out difficult questions so that I can put something to teachers so that the whole class becomes on that. I don't know how many master students do such things this day. Arjun. And during my graduation, my best book which I gave to my all the teachers, I gifted books. My present was books. That's my notebook. And I gave class note to all teachers in Kolkata. And English, I was not good in English. Even now I am not good in English. But improved a lot. I am from a small Malayalam medium, remote village. What I did was, in graduation at Macbeth, I translated the whole thing and sat in the classroom. Because I thought that's the best way to learn. From then, every chapter, I translated into Malayalam. And that was fun. And that's why I could learn Telugu, Kannada, Tamil, wherever I go, I translate this into something else. Tingle, tingle, trista, merpu, merpu, akashamalu, I translate in Telugu also. So language learning is a thrill. By learning language, what are you doing? Going into the concept of the subject. Without understanding, you cannot translate, right? So do this. Tell your children to do that. When you run a college with 100 teachers and 1000 children, you are running a factory with 1000 employers, 100 managers. You can do one this. Lot of productive activity can be done. Lot of creative things can be done. Otherwise, it will just run routinely like many other places. Then try to be innovative. Try to be creative. If you want to be innovative and creative, you have to sharpen your weapon. That's only the thing. I think that's enough.
Sir, yeah.
Because we often feel that language power is one of the strengths of education. We in this campus, in our campus, the authorities, including your manager and the principal, always insist on the teachers that you should try to speak or communicate with the students in English so that they also get the power of the language. One objection in this regard, my humble observation, is that with regard to part of the government, they unnecessarily glorify, you know, I often tell my students, if only you love your own mother, then only you can love somebody else's mother. മലയാള ഭാഷയിൽ ആവുന്നത്ര സ്വാധീനമുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അത് ആർജിച്ചെടുക്കാൻ കഴിയുന്നെങ്കിൽ മാത്രമേ യു ക്യാൻ ബെറ്റർ യുവർസെൽഫ് ഇൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ആസ് വല്ലാത്ത ഒരു കൺഫ്യൂഷൻ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ബിക്കോസ് വൺ ഓഫ് ദ ചലഞ്ചസ് ഐ ഫീൽ ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ്സ് ഓൾസോ എ വെരി നമ്പർ ഒബ്സർവേഷൻ സെൻസ് ജസ്റ്റ് ഇൻ എ ജസ്റ്റ് ഇൻ ടൈം മേ ബി ദി ഇന്റർനെറ്റ് കൾച്ചർ ഇസ് ദർ ഇഫ് ഓൾ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് ദ ആർ വെരി ലെതാർജിക് ലേസി ആസ് യു സ്റ്റഡി ഇൻ ദ മോർണിംഗ് ടു ദ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് No preparation is needed. Beyond that, type the matter, type the subject. Even the net will ask, is what you meant? See, that culture is, with regard to teachers also, that is not an exception. It is, that's one of the greatest dangers. I am a retired principal. One of the greatest dangers, rightly observed by you, when a class is given to the students, teachers should be there. Otherwise, how can we be the teachers? With regard to language power, how many, including myself, how many of us try to improve our English so that, because ഭാഷ പഠിക്കുന്നത് സംസാരിച്ച് മാത്രമേ പറ്റൂ സാധാരണ ചെയ്തു ചർച്ച ചെയ്തു സംസാരിക്കുന്നു തെറ്റുണ്ടാകും പക്ഷേ മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ ക്യാമ്പസസ് ഇൻ ഇൻ കേരള when we go outside in Wales and Christ they make it a point that old people communicate in English because I have been there for some talks or some for attending some seminars what is your reflection on this
it's not language which is a barrier for students today in Malayalam also if they ask if you ask somebody to write very specific today afternoon I am going to meet students I will do first exercise to prove that They don't even have idea, right? It's not language. Let them make language. And English is such a wonderful language where last two letters are correct. You can fill in anything between, you can read that. Therefore, people do a lot of mistakes. Somebody asked for a class from a wonderful school, great, great, one of the best, writes to me on a text, Sir, I want to meet you. M-E-A-T-H. I've got many. I get more than 1,000 WhatsApp. And if you look at it, a lot of mistakes. Palakkad, one of the districts, called all the principals of neighboring schools. I conducted a program. I asked them to write a small chit and then give it to me. On allocation competition, what topics can be given today? My intention was to know how much knowledge they have on current affairs. Many of them wrote and gave it to me. Out of 23, 17 of them wrote something regarding education. E-D-U-C-A-T-I-O-N. They don't know the spelling. 17 of them had mistakes in the word education. Or maybe senior most teacher deputed by the master to attend such a program. That's a standard. So most of them are careless. They don't invest time. I tell them if you want to be good communicator in English, it's very simple. At 1 year, a child who don't speak any language, when they become 3 or 4 years, they can communicate without a grammar mistake, their mother tongue. Fine? So by up to 10th grade, if they could grab a language, 18,000 words only they will learn in their mother tongue. They learn equivalent number of other tongue also during this time. Because most of the words which we use in Malayalam are English words. Mic, chair, shirt, pen, watch, cell phone. Then in between only they have to add something, right? What they don't have is a courage. Second one, if somebody start talking in English, they think that, oh sorry. That's what happened. The other day I tell you there is a big letter of complaint gone against me from one of the WWS national workshop. I mean state workshop happened at one of the university center. Wherein first day 9:30 the coordinator Raju Krishnan sir was explaining the rules of the camp. It's all one college, one student selected, you must realize. Each college one student is attending. Under the university the program happened. And I had the first session, first talk is by me. Raju Krishna sir is explaining from 9:30 to 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock is my session. So there are 57 students from 57 different colleges. Each one, they just came in the morning. So as they came, a number is given. As per the number, 1, 2, 3, up to 57, they were sitting. And he is taking a lot and then saying, roll number 25 is going to be the leader for the camp. It's a random selection. So there are two boys, one girl, two boys, and the girl happened to be the one who is the leader. I was sitting two seats back. So I am able to see all the time these five children were talking, non-stop. Nothing from the Raja Krishna sir was going into their brain. That's all it is. What you should do, who should do, how to do, everything was explained. Nothing is going into them because they are busy. Right? And then the 25 number came, she moved 25, and the leader. So she was just coming out, the other two fellows said, only Malayalam man. Instruction, only 1 hour, no? Not even 1 hour, half an hour only they have interaction. The boy could influence the girl, and he gives instruction that you should speak only in Malayalam. Raja Krishna sir was talking in English, so the expected WWS student should have good communicative English. They should communicate in English only. The girl came, started talking in Malayalam. Nobody objected. Raja Krishna also did not object. She went and sat there. First session was mine. So I said, three of you come. And I said, the whole half an hour talk which Raja Krishna sir gave you, explain it. And the boy said, English, I don't understand. I said, quit and go. Why are you attending a program? Or you should have told, I don't understand. Correct? And then he asked this girl, why you introduce yourself in Malayalam but not in English? So she said, sir, Malayalam is acceptable to everybody, not English. I said, don't. I heard, I was just sitting in this backside. Sorry, back. And then I heard that you are telling this. The person who was sitting beside you were telling that you should speak in Malayalam. That's the reason you did. Yes, sir. I asked the boy which college you are from. So he said the college. And I said that college I went once and I know the experience. The college itself has got only that much standard. Because I told this among all the other college students, he must have told and added maybe 100 times. Because that's the boy who influenced this girl. I said, you are coming here to learn or to influence a girl? It's a question they asked, 100% they asked. I said, discipline is must. Right? And he wrote a long letter. Anyway, I am not an employee of Kerala government. I am not an employee of academic system here. Nobody is going to suspend me. Nobody can take action against me. But this is the attitude. Children go. They have a feeling that anybody who speaks English is not in our company. Correct or not? If you want to get company, you should speak mother tongue. I think that culture should go. And you can insist in your classroom that they should communicate only in English. I do as much as I can, otherwise I could have spoken. But when we make jokes, sometimes it doesn't reach the numbers I use Malayalam. So I left. But use it only for that purpose. Otherwise insist English. I'm sure if you know your mother tongue, ഇത് പറയുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് എനിക്ക് മലയാളം സംസാരിക്കാൻ അറിയില്ല എന്നുള്ള ലാഘവം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ആ തോന്നൽ ആർക്കെങ്കിലും ഉണ്ടെങ്കിലും മാറ്റാൻ വേണ്ടിയാണ് മലയാളം പറയുന്നുണ്ടാവും. ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ദറ്റ് ഐ ട്രാൻസ്ലേറ്റ് മഗവത് മാക്ബത്ത്. ഐ ഓൾസോ ലേൺ ദ ഹോൾ ശിഷ്യനും മകനും ഫുൾ ബൈ ഹാർട്ട്. ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് ദറ്റ് ഐ റൈറ്റ് ഓൺലി ഇൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ്, ഐ റൈറ്റ് ഇൻ മലയാളം. എല്ലാ ലാംഗ്വേജിലും അതിൽ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻസ് ഉണ്ട്. ബട്ട് ഇഫ് യു ഡോണ്ട്, യു വിൽ ഫെയിൽ ഇൻ യുവർ ഇന്റർവ്യൂസ്. മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് അവർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ ഇൻ കേരള, it is understood, we have got good brain, good analytical skill, good logical reasoning, but lacking in communication skill. I think if there is a student who can communicate well, they score much higher than most of the other students. So make them to feel, and it should start from day one. There can be problems. I just saw two students from Vayakkara. Vayakkara is a remote village from my place, Kasaragod district and Kannur district border, very close to Karnataka border. Two students, I'm sure in that school, if they have studied some 2 years or maybe 12 years, they will never had an opportunity, they never would have had an opportunity to speak to somebody in English, though it would have been English language. But I am sure you can make a difference and then prove to them in next 1 month in your whole program should be with a lot of communicative English students. Otherwise, it's going to be difficult. Orient them who don't have this ability to communicate, to write out. Very, very essential to have ideas and write. They only beat around the bush. They don't know how to write specifically. It's essential. Very, very essential. Yeah. Fine? Okay? So, see you. Bye-bye.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much, dear sir, for being here with us and for igniting our mind's eye so that we all become eternal learners and try to instill this passion for eternal learning wherever we go, like be it in our classrooms, be it elsewhere, and be it anywhere. Thank you very much.